Hello ladies and gentlemen, this is BestInSlot, and in tonight's video we're going to discuss some potentially very exciting Jurassic World Evolution 2 news. I say that with a big old bag of truck of salt, right? Imagine a truck. It's not carrying salt, but it's made of salt. It's a salty truck. Anyways, we'll get into that in just a second. But the Late Cretaceous DLC basically just came out a few days ago, 4 or 3 days ago now, and it seems like Frontier may already be hard at work on the next DLC, which we would expect to pop up probably in December if they're sticking to their usual 3-month-ish timeline, which so far for Evolution 2, they've been better at than they were with Evolution 1, so it's pretty cool so far. Now, what am I talking about? Well, this image right here has been circulating on the subreddit lately, posted by HeyRLegitLit, and I believe it was first discovered by Anaki over on the modding Discord. And basically what people can do is use a file browser, InfoRapid in this case, and search through game files. Files that you own, essentially, or you have in your Steam game, blah blah blah. They are on your computer right now if you own this game on PC. And you can search through the files, and people tend to do this post-update to see if Frontier's slipped anything new in there or taken anything out, yada yada yada. And what people discovered is a lot of references to the word zipline. Now, before we continue, it is worth mentioning, as it always is, that truck made out of salt, okay? Because there have been files found in this game for a long time that never appeared in-game. Coronosaurus, for example, has been in the game files for generations and never makes it into the actual game. There were cow and pig feeders in the Jurassic World Evolution 2 files from release, basically, from when the game first came out. There were even icons for those feeders, and they've never made it into the game. We still live in hope, but they never made it into the game. This happens a lot in game dev. You're going to put files in, you're going to test things out. There's no guarantee that they'll actually make it into the final version of the game. So I just want to say that this doesn't guarantee anything at all. It's a little more convincing because they were added now. They were added, you know, later into the game's life with the latest update, and it would suggest that's being worked on for the next update, but no guarantees at all. Don't get disappointed if this doesn't happen. I'm just bringing you the information, okay? All right, cool. So, zipline. How does that make sense? Well, there has been a zipline already in the Jurassic World franchise. If we go back to Jurassic World Camp Cretaceous in the earlier seasons, there was a zip. I think there was a season 2, if I remember correctly. There was a zipline present. We can see Darius here riding it, and it's basically a zipline, like a wire string kind of thing, with a pole hanging down from it, a little seat, and then you strap yourself in. To me, it looks immensely dangerous. I'm not gonna lie, it does not look safe by any metric whatsoever. But that's the zipline we have, and you can go past and zoom past all the dinosaurs and have a little look. Preferably not in a carnivorous habitat, but you never know. And you see here, we've got another little image of it. It's always connected by these big, tall wooden towers. So if a zipline were to be added to the game, it's not necessarily going to be connected to Camp Cretaceous. We've been asking for, and this is another reason I'm partially convinced by this, we've been asking for new attractions for a really long time. It has been top of my list personally for a really long time, and I know it is from your comments from so many of you at home. And Frontier is, to credit them, usually really good at reacting to what people want, to what the general public want, to what the fans want, to what the players want. They tend to address that in the game eventually. And I've been saying this for so long it feels stupid to keep saying it, but I would be surprised if we never got new attractions in Jurassic World Evolution 2. New ways for our guests to interact with our parks, new ways for our guests to view our dinosaurs, interact with our dinosaurs, etc, etc. So maybe this is the turning of the tide. And that is no guarantee if there is a zipline that it's anything to do with Camp Cretaceous. Of course, it could simply just be a typical nondescript zipline ride from point A to point B. Maybe it's in a little carriage or something, not necessarily sitting like this. Who knows? No guarantees it's like this. But if they were to do a Camp Cretaceous Part 2 pack, which I would find surprising, given we still don't have the multi-pack that we were expecting. But if they were to do it, what else could it possibly contain? We're going to very quickly talk about that, because there is some scope for some other attraction kind of things, but also new species, like for example the Nothosaurus, which appeared in season 5. Now, I haven't seen season 5 because I don't care too much about the show, if I'm totally honest, but I am interested in seeing some of the creatures from the show come into the game. Nothosaurus is, I believe, semi-aquatic, semi-oceanic, lives in both the ocean and on land. I know it does both in the series as well. It's got a kind of bizarre, overtly brutalized, angry-looking aesthetic, but it'd be a really interesting creature. The inherent problem with it, of course, is that we don't currently have an ability for animals to transition from water to land. Animals are either wet or never wet, basically. A theory I had, however, if you wanted to bring this in without inventing a whole new amphibious aquatic, semi-aquatic mechanic, is that you'd have two nothosauruses. You'd have a terrestrial version and you would have a lagoon version, and you could use the same model and just have to give it a different animation set. Small theory there. Smilodon, of course, is another one of the big missing ones from the last Camp Cretaceous pack, probably the biggest missing one, I would suggest. It would be really interesting now as well, post-Dominion DLC. Of course, feathers and fur and all that kind of stuff is now officially in the game, so Smilodon would be a really good way to showcase that. Of course, it would be a whole new type. It would be our first mammal ever. It would be our first sort of post-dinosaur creature. There'd be a lot of new things here, and I think the Smilodon's design doesn't really fit into Jurassic World Evolution at all. It would require some finagling, and actually the difficulty of the Nothosaurus and the slightly weird design and the fact that the Smilodon's a mammal is two things that make me think that it's probably not a Camp Cretaceous pack, and it's probably just a zipline, maybe derived from Camp Cretaceous style, but not really from a Camp Cretaceous pack specifically. That's my current theory, but who knows. But Smilodon would be a really, really interesting addition, to say the least. And then finally, of course, I believe it's called the Sino-Spino, which is our Sinoceratops-Spinosaurus hybrid. I much prefer Spinoceratops, that's what we're going to call it. But the Sino-Spino hybrid from the past series, we only saw it as a baby, of course. It could appear in baby form, but I imagine you'd scale it up, make it an adult, and de-cartoonify it a little bit in the process, basically. And that would be it for new species. I don't think there's any seen new species that haven't been included in the game yet. However, there is room for other things. For example, Little E.T. In the last update, we got Big E.T., but we didn't get Little E.T. So Little E.T. would... God, I hate those names. Little E.T. would make a lot of sense as an inclusion. Why not round out the roster a little bit more? The Spinosaurus, seen in Season 4... is people are determined that either this is or isn't the Spinosaurus from Jurassic Park 3. People cannot make their minds up. It's clearly visually different, but some people suggest that's from aging. I really don't want to get into that. People care so much about the canon for this series when the people who make the series don't give a damn about the canon at all, because it's a convoluted, nonsensical mess. But even if it's not a new... even if it's not a different Spinosaurus, that doesn't matter. It looks entirely different. Visually, it's got all that colour drained out of it. The head shape is slightly different, yada, yada, yada. So there's no reason this couldn't be a new variant of the Spinosaurus, essentially. We saw some mod makers do that fairly recently to really, really cool results. Same goes for the Brachiosaurus. I think this is called Firecracker. Baby dinosaurs, I feel, is a topic they probably don't want to broach. So a couple of these suggestions probably won't get through because of that, if this is indeed a Camp Cretaceous pack. I feel like once you start to add some baby dinosaurs, people start to get annoyed that, you know, we don't have baby dinosaurs for everything, which is just never going to happen. I mean, I'd love it if it did, but it's never going to happen. But, you know, just chucking in a couple of the famous ones from the series would not necessarily be a bad idea. I think it would make a lot of sense. And I think this little firecracker, this little baby Brachiosaurus, would make a lot of people very happy. And would be a really good way to sell the pack, if nothing else. So... I personally think the payoff would be worth it, and that would be worth that risk, but who knows. And of course, possibly the biggest omission from the Camp Cretaceous pack, and again we're back in the baby dinosaur territory, is Bumpy, but in the baby form. Bumpy is really the only reason I cared about Camp Cretaceous, if I'm totally honest. Baby Bumpy is adorable, and I'm a big fan, and yeah, it would again need a little tweaking to look a little bit less cartoonish, a little bit more Jurassic World-ish, but... I think Baby Bumpy is what brought a lot of people into the series in the first place, and would of course be a heavy hitter in terms of sale numbers. So in terms of species, it's definitely, obviously there's less room than there was previously because we've already had a pack on this, but there's definitely scope to maybe have a building slash attraction slash mechanic focused expansion, and yet still throw a few new dinosaur species in there, a few new prehistoric species, and some new variants and stuff like that. There may even be more than this that I haven't mentioned yet. I believe the Velociraptors are a specific... I know blue is in the series, but I believe the green ones are a specific to Camp Cretaceous Velociraptor. Anyways... of course, there's a little bit more you could do as well. If we're going to go down the attraction routes, then why not also have the attraction that people have probably been asking for more than any other attraction in the history of Jurassic World Evolution, and that is some form of river ride kind of thing. Now, I've been thinking a lot about how you would do this. Of course, we've not just seen it here in Camp Cretaceous, it was also in Jurassic World, it was also in Jurassic Park, even if it never made it into the film. There was meant to be, it's from the book, there's a whole scene with the Rex in the river and everything. Kind of got taken over to Jurassic Park 3 in some ways. I always said that the water in this game wouldn't allow you to do something like this. Basically, it just, because of how the water functions, this kind of thing wouldn't be possible. But I've been thinking about that a lot lately, and I'm going to take that back. Because what I think you could do, potentially, is you would rig this just like you do the tour truck ride, for example. And basically what you do is you have a... You'd have to do it so the dinosaurs can't cross over the path. And what you would do is you just have your tour go around, and then underneath wherever you put your tour, you'd have a model of a river, essentially. You'd build the river underneath the tour track, and there'd be flowing water there, but it'd be very controlled. Right? It's going to be the same thickness all the way around, and then you can sort of build around it. The dinosaurs can't cross over it. So the dinosaurs never have to interact with the water, and the water isn't real per se. It's not real volumetric water. It's kind of just like a model that sits underneath the tour track. And I think that would actually be a viable way to make this happen without changing the water mechanics in Jurassic World Evolution 2. That said, between this and the Nothosaurus and everything, maybe a change to the water mechanics wouldn't necessarily be a bad thing. Maybe like a deep water mechanic would be good. Then you have to deal with the problem of dinosaurs swimming or just using it as a barrier, but then it becomes a free barrier instead of a fence, which is a problem I've talked about before. It's a bit complicated, and I do not envy Frontier for having to try to deal with it, frankly. But that would be my suggestion. Oh no, of course, and also the... you know, it's just a random model kind of thing. You can stick in the treehouse as well. You could even have that as an attraction. You know, it's up in the trees. Have it as a walking area up in the trees, or like a viewing area or something like that. The point is, even though we've already had a Camp Cretaceous pack, there is scope for more. I mean, we talked about this because this is the logical way you would interpret a zipline. I still think this probably isn't a Camp Cretaceous pack, personally, because I think if you exclude the baby dinosaurs, there isn't enough here to justify a pack in a way. Like, then it would be a little bit light on the ground. They'd have to go heavy on the attractions and stuff. You need at least two or three. I would love like just an attractions pack. I have no idea how well that would sell though. I'm not in marketing or anything, so the point is there is scope here for possibility. However, it could well just be an attractions pack. It could well be something free for like the anniversary or something, you know, just as a free update. Here's a new attraction. It could be an attractions pack, nothing to do with Camp Cretaceous. It could be a multi-pack and they threw some attractions in there. It could be part of the free update and it's nothing to do with anything, and then we're going to get the multi-pack and then we'll get the free update and we'll also get the attractions. There is tons of possibilities. It could be nothing. It could never make it into the game, ever. But it is promising that they're at least thinking about this kind of thing, the attractions, the thing that we all want so much. And I am cautiously optimistic, and I will remain there. It's important to remember, especially if you've been on the internet this week. If you've been on the internet this week, you've seen the Grand Theft Auto 6 leak, and that's a very, very different thing, of course. That's an entire game being spilled well ahead of time. People are ripping it apart based on what they're seeing. This is obviously a very different situation, although it is making me feel a little bit bad now that I'm discussing this at all, because I think that leak is quite damaging to people, and I hope this isn't. I don't think it would be. I genuinely don't think it would be, but I'm slightly nervous now. I feel kind of bad. But we'll press on for now. But the point is, people had a really stupid reaction to that Grand Theft Auto 6 leak. And it's because people don't understand game dev, basically. The point is, attaching your hopes to something that isn't guaranteed, attaching your hopes to something that may never make it in, is a very silly thing to do. I think this is interesting, and I think it shows potential, at least that they're considering it, but that's really all it has to be at this point in time. That's all it has to be right now. And it is worth crediting Frontier, because the last free update they did was obviously fantastic, and they keep adding really good things to the game in that response. Regardless of what I felt about the Late Cretaceous DLC itself, the free update was really, really good. And I like what they've been doing with Evolution 2 so far. Anyways, I'm gonna go. So, thank you very much for joining me. Let me know what you think in the comment section down below. Let me know what other attractions you would like to see in the game. What would be your number one pick, other than the river tour and a zipline? You know, what other attractions could they add? Maybe the log thing from the T-Rex Kingdom. Maybe the viewing thing, the viewing dome. Maybe helicopter. I can't believe there's not been a helicopter tour yet. It seems like such an obvious inclusion to me. It'd be so easy. It would be so easy. I can't believe it's not a thing yet. But you never know. It's always one for the future. Either way, thank you so much for joining me. I'll see you lovely folks very soon. Throw me a like down below if you enjoyed the video. Cheers much of as always. Bye-bye.
reaching out.